Today, I'm going to walk you through writing unit tests to test a simple service that converts a date format to a different format. So let's start the setup by opening the terminal and initializing in Composer project. I will put the quiet flag and let's name our project date service. And we add the autoload flag with the A and we write the source. This will allow us to import our service using the PHP use keyword. And we wrote source because our service is in the source directory. This command will create a vendor directory and a composer JSON file that will contain our dependencies and project configuration. It wrote the name as we wrote in our command, and the autoload date service is mapped to the source directory. Now let's navigate to our service to ensure that it has the correct namespace. Let's correct the namespace as it defined in the composer JSON file, and let's navigate back to our composer JSON to install the PHP unit that is used for the unit testing. We can use the terminal composer require unit test, and let's put the def flag because this dependency is only required in development environment. Successfully installed. Let's create a namespace for our test by copying the entry and changing it to a date test namespace, and the directory should be the test, a non-existent directory that we will create using our IDE. And let us create a class into it that is called format date test. As a naming convention, the test class should have the method or the class name you'd like to test, and test with uppercase T. Let's extend the PHP unit test case and let's create the class. First, let me clean up the import. And then I will write a test method. As a naming convention, test method should start with lowercase test and the name of our test. The purpose of this video is to successfully install PHP unit and to ensure that it works. Therefore, let's purposely fail our test and write a message from our test. Now let's open the terminal and run the test using the vendor bin PHP unit. And as you see, our test failed successfully. I will expand the terminal to ensure that our message we provided is here. And there is our message. Very nice, our test seems to be working. One thing we can improve here, and that is minimizing our test command because it is long. We can do that in the composer JSON using the script key test, and let's assign it to a value that will be executed when this key is called. For us now, this is PHP vendor bin PHP unit command. Let's add our directory. And to better format the output of the test in the console, we add the test docs flag. And that's it. Let's run our new command using the composer test. Our command seems to call the correct value. And finally, our test failed successfully. Ladies and gentlemen, this was how to set up composer and PHP unit and test using the native PHP unit command and the composer test. Next, we will set up the PHP storm so that we can run our test in the IDE. I hope you enjoyed watching and see you next time.